Hello there, ladies, gentlemen, and unicorns. Welcome to the very last part in my video series on the making of the Ludum Dare 41 keynote. This time, we're taking a closer look at sound and audio and all those little finishing touches until I was able to upload the finished film for good. Now, with the edit complete and the first couple of VFX shots in there, it certainly did look right, but it didn't sound right. And we all know that a big part of anything is audio and sound. In my film, I had four main parts or four main audio tracks that were ambience, dialogue, sound effects, and music. So let's first look into the dialogue track, which is everything that is spoken. As complex and difficult it is to shoot all those split screens, well, there was at least one upside to it. I could get the mic in pretty close, as it would be covered up with my interlocutor on either side. This resulted in pretty solid recordings throughout, provided I didn't turn my head away from the mic, which occasionally happened.
Working on it!
And once the edit was final, I exported all the dialogue tracks and scrubbed them squeaky clean. This meant removing all the noise floor in the signal, all the mouth noises that I'd make, any low frequency rumble, and yeah, pretty much anything that didn't belong in there. But right now I'm still working here on doing the audio mix. I'm inside Reaper here. The pink stuff here is all voice acting audio, which I cleaned up one by one, removed the noise and such, because yeah, it was quite noisy with my little test cam recorder. I would like to say that I'm just putting on some finishing touches, while in reality it's just scrambling to get this thing out of the door with everything that I need in there, but we're getting there. Back to work. As I've said now multiple times, I shot the whole thing at night. But even once it looked like it was daytime, it still didn't feel like daytime, because on the audio and sound, it was missing something. And this is where the ambience came in. I put some very subtle bird chirps and yeah, just outside ambience over it, which I recorded in the mornings when I was still working on VFX. I just put my little field recorder on the windowsill and recorded for half an hour just what was going on. When also I wanted to record some typical Minecraft atmosphere, I realized that in Minecraft there's nothing. No pointless ambience that's just there in the game. Instead, all sounds are triggered by player actions or mobs. In my despair, I recorded some sheep baaing as typical Minecraft sounds. I always underestimate the amount of sound effects necessary, be it for films or for games. It's just that everything makes a sound and has to make a sound. I recorded my watch beeping, dice rolling, Super Mario Land on Game Boy, but also NES game sounds, ripped some samples from Minecraft, and just bought what I couldn't pick up myself, like the explosion and lightning. As you know, there are many instances of Phil and Future Phil transitioning into and out of the time tunnel. It always should make a sound, but I didn't want it to sound repetitive. I thought it to be a nice challenge to buckle down and build a synthesizer chain in Reason. This is the result. I call it the Portalist. Just turn a few knobs and hit the keys, and you get a new portal sound each time. And lastly, there was the artificial environment of the time tunnel. I really had no clear vision of how to design it. I only wanted it to be droning and otherworldly and maybe a little bit echoey. And with that vision, I just started experimenting. The basis for everything is our humming fridge. I experimented a lot, sped things up and down, applied equalizers, phase effects, reverb, until it sounded much more ominous. As for the iconic TARDIS sound, I didn't even bother trying to recreate it myself because I could only fail. So instead I went straight to the source and found this BBC report of the BBC Radiophonic Workshop, which also had some audio snippets. The quality wasn't overwhelming, but that's okay. The sound had to come through the mix just a little to be recognizable. Still missing was the musical score, but I felt that I had more pressing issues at the time. The edit was complete, the audio pretty final, apart from the lack of music, but it was enough that I could start with all those small things that also needed to be done, such as subtitles. Because Ludum Dare is an international event, and not everyone's mother tongue is English, such as mine, I wanted to subtitle the whole film, because I probably don't get all the pronunciation right. Sometimes there are words that are hard to understand, or in general, it's good for people with hearing impairments. I didn't feel like typing out everything from scratch again. So I uploaded a black video with just the dialogue audio as a private video to YouTube, and have its algorithm automatically transcribe it. It transcribes about 90% correctly, but also requires a lot of manual labor. For one thing, the auto-generated subtitles are just a stream of words, all lowercase, no punctuation, and not easy to read. I thought the fixing process to be 2 hours, but it took me more than twice that long. Pro tip, don't forget to proofread. Instead of finishing the music already, I instead turned my attention towards making the whole thing look as pretty and good as it possibly could. And you do this via color grading. You see, my day job is that of a colorist for film and TV, so of course it was out of question for me that I would employ my digital color magic also for my own things.
I mean, it's Monday now and this video should launch on Wednesday. And there's still a lot of stuff to do. So right now, while I'm waiting to be again in the mood for some music, I'm doing the color grading. I already got the full video in here. And color grading actually means just making it look nice. I can change the color here with my trackballs, but yeah, this is not what it's going to look like.
Here are a few examples of what it looked like straight from the camera and after color grading.
Those games have been made before you got that damn Game Boy.
Huh. Okay.
But color grading was not only about making it look pretty. Some shots really relied on these final touches in the color stage to make them work even. For example, the Minecraft world gradually transitions from sunset to night as the scene plays out. And to get that across seamlessly, most of it happened in color grading. Also, the shots pretending to be daylight shots got some little touch-ups. In some, it meant adding a subtle blue gradient from the side. In other shots, the blown out windows are entirely achieved with a mask in my color grading software. So in the end, I achieved this daylight appeal in the film by a combination of onset lighting, audio ambience, and color grading. But what I couldn't fake any longer was the lack of music. My procrastination kept me ignoring that vital aspect of my film for way too long, up until to a point where I literally had to face the music. Since the whole film was an homage to the Back to the Future trilogy anyway, I couldn't just stop at the music and use some old Ludum Dare music that I made previously anyway. So instead, early on even, I decided to make something that would feel like the Back to the Future soundtrack.
Great Scott!
So after shooting the first scene, when it still felt like that I had all the time in the world, I started research on the music. I got myself the Back to the Future 1 soundtrack and listened to it on repeat for days, just to get a feel for the soundtrack. I'm anything but a classically trained composer or even trained in music at all. So I knew that all my efforts would only scratch at the surface, but still I thought, well, I could give it a shot anyway. The first thing that I started with was this piece for Future Phil that was heavily inspired by the music for Doc Brown in the first Back to the Future film. Here's Future Phil's theme as it plays inside Reaper. Not as playful and scatterbrained as I would have liked it to sound, but for starters, it was good enough. I mean, I could come back to it anyway. But I didn't, and for long stretches, just the visual effects occupied me enough, until I came back to the film and saw how much music there was still lacking. For example, there was this big scene with Kid Phil in the 80s, which just sounded eerie when there was no music playing. I didn't know how to tackle it until my wife suggested, why not use the Turtles theme song? And this was what really got the ball rolling for me. I wanted an 80s version of this. Heroes in a half shell, turtle power. An entire night I just tweaked synths for a cheesy new wave cover of the Turtles song, but it just didn't sound right. It was too agitated for the scene and also a little bit too short. Out of exhaustion, I did the sensible thing and halved its tempo to just make it long enough for the scene. And it worked. So if you play it at double speed, it's very recognizable. Still, I had a staggering amount of footage without music. And I was really running short on time. And for the first time in my life, I was crunching on music.
Hello, it is already Tuesday. It's 2:30 in the morning. And I'm at the keyboard, trying to make some music for the last part. All those little bits here, those are music, and this is the whole track that I still need to fill somehow. 5 minutes worth of music in one night, in a couple of hours, it's almost impossible. Actually, I don't know how I make this or if I will make it, but right now I'm very frustrated because all the music that I make, I mean, there are some pretty interesting concepts and moods there, but none fit this quirky bit in the final part. And I've run out of ideas for making quirky stuff. So far I've kept every deadline and this won't be any different. I just hope it doesn't suck too much.
I couldn't help it any longer to not put the Back to the Future motif anywhere in. I was getting very tired, and it felt so natural that before the final scene, I went all in.
Yes, everything has music and sound, and even this one here. I hope I can get away with that.
The second time Future Phil mentions that he'd go back to the future, I had 6 short notes to really hit the point home.
It's 7:15 in the morning and music is done. I still need to render it out, still need to do a little bit of mixing. Oh god, this is it has been like a Ludum Dare game jam just with this video. And right now it's close to submission hour, but I'm pretty much done. Thank you. It's close to 8 a.m.
And I think I'm done. This is the final edit here with the credits. I had, of course, to change the credits now that I made something that sounds a lot like Back to the Future, so I had to mention this in the credits as well. The only thing I need to do now is hit render. And it's rendering.
I will go to sleep and let's knock on wood that it renders until I get up again. It is Tuesday, 3 p.m. for a change. And this one here is the final video. It's what I call release candidate number one. I will watch it together with Connie now and we will see if there's anything that doesn't look right or doesn't sound right and catch pretty much any errors that are that might be still in there. Okay, so we're done with the first viewing and it's not that bad. It's really, it's just two things. The music with the first stuff starts too loudly and there's a typo in the credits. Could have been much worse, I still like the music.
After those final fixes, I could send the locked, very, very final file to rendering and left for work. Hello there, ladies, gentlemen, and unicorns. One more time, I checked how the video appeared on YouTube and sent the link to Mike. And to my big relief, he seemed to like it.
And it's done.
Time to take a deep breath and wait.
It's out there now.
When Mike posted the official Ludum Dare 41 announcement with my keynote, it didn't take long for the first reactions to come in.
And already 50 views. And 5 comments. I'm so relieved that it's finally done and especially that it's finally out there. When you're working so long on a video, there are times when you think, if I stop working now, if I don't post it, or if something happens, right? No one ever gets to see this and it was all in vain. So yeah, this is why I'm so happy that it's out now. And yeah, I got Twitter, already got 12 notifications on Twitter. It's a big day for me, it's a big day for me. So yeah, I will finish up here at work as soon as I can and then I will head home and celebrate with my lovely wife and maybe with some ice cream. If you still have any. Oh my god, we're out of ice cream!
And that's the making of the Ludum Dare 41 keynote from inception to upload. Even with a couple of weeks distance, I'm still very proud of the whole thing as it has been my biggest project so far. And I'm so glad that I received so many likes and shares and comments and subscribers and Patreon pledges. It's just great. So thank you so much for your support and your feedback that really helped me see it through till the end. I'm pretty sure that I won't be needing those shirts and shoes anymore. That's why I decided to donate them to the local charity. Oh, you're still watching. You must find this whole thing then very interesting. Well, in that case, I got a few goodies for you. Are you interested in what it cost me to make this whole thing? Do you want to look at my storyboards or thumb through the final script with all my notes on it? Well, you can. I put links to all those resources in the description, so you can just dig around my archive. And if you want to support me in making more videos like this, why not consider dropping me a donation over at pixelprophecy.com/donate. There you can buy me a cup of coffee or a candy bar, and if you want to go all in and become a monthly sustainer, you can over at patreon.com/pixelprophecy. Even if it's just a buck a month, it really means a lot to me knowing that people like you support me and that the stuff that I'm doing is of worth to you. So, that's it from my side with this year. I think the next time we will see each other when I have something related to the Ludum Dare 41 post-mortem. Well, until then, take care and see you around.